Porque eres bueno siempre, Señor amado. Y siempre eres bueno. We thank you for a place of worship. Te damos gracias por un lugar de adoración. We thank you, Lord God, for your blessing upon our lives. Gracias por tu bendición sobre nuestra vida. For your blessing during the day and your blessing and comfort during the night. Gracias por la bendición durante el día y tu bendición y consuelo durante la noche, Señor. We pray for our Jewish brothers in Pennsylvania and Pittsburgh. Oramos por nuestros hermanos judíos en Pittsburgh. We pray for their families. We pray for comfort. Oramos por sus familias. Oramos por consuelo. We pray, oh Lord God, that you would be with the whole city. Oramos que tú estés con toda aquella ciudad, with the community, con la comunidad, that you are here, and you are also there, que estás aquí, pero que también estás allá. Let them feel that presence. Que ellos sientan esa presencia. We pray for the family of the man that did such a thing. We pray, Lord God, that you would save, Lord God, and you would restore. Señor, oramos por la familia de la persona que cometió tal cosa. Oramos que tú salves. Oramos que tú restaures, Señor. Glorify your holy name, Lord God. Let there be justice. Permite, oh Dios, que haya justicia. Glorifica tu santo nombre. We give you the glory and the honor. We pray for this class, the class of the young people, the children's class. Oramos por esta clase, la clase de los jóvenes, la clase de los niños. And we pray, oh Lord, that you would move powerfully, that you would speak life into our lives, Lord God. Que tú hables vida a nuestra vida, Señor. And take the glory and the honor for your glory name. Llévate la gloria y la honra para la gloria de tu nombre. And the church says, y la iglesia dice, amen. Give God praise, amen. Hallelujah. Welcome to Wednesday night Bible class. Bienvenido a la clase de los miércoles por la noche. It is our small little university. En nuestra clase de universidad. I'm talking to you about the signs of the end times. Le estoy hablando de las señales de el tiempo del final. We have gone through so much. Hemos pasado por tanto. There's no way I can go back and review. No hay una forma que pueda regresar y repasar. But right in YouTube, on our channel, in YouTube, en nuestro canal, you can see the past classes. Puedes ver las clases pasadas in YouTube. Today, before I move on, there was a question last week that I want to address this tonight. Antes de proseguir, había una pregunta, hubo una pregunta la semana pasada que quiero enseñarle un poco esta semana, esta noche. There is a difference between the rapture of the church and the second coming of Christ. Okay? Hay una diferencia entre el rapto de la iglesia y la segunda venida de Cristo. Many people will utilize verses interchangeably. Hay personas que utilizan ciertos versos intercambiablemente, but the truth is there's a difference. There's a difference. I want you to know what the difference is. Quiero que sepas cuál es la diferencia, because one of them, actually both of them involve you as a church. Ambas de ellas lo envuelve a usted como la iglesia. Everybody sees the screen, and if you're at home, you don't see it. But I took the time to post it on our Facebook page, the charts. Muchos de ustedes en el hogar no lo ven, pero tomé el tiempo de poner estas láminas en nuestra página en Facebook. Facebook, not YouTube, okay? Y así usted lo puede ver allá en su hogar. That way you can see it at home. So, as we're talking about the difference between the rapture of the church and the second coming of Christ, estamos hablando sobre la diferencia entre el rapto de la iglesia y la segunda venida de Cristo. I want you to know, just notice here, God's work with Israel, el trabajo de Dios con Israel, up to the cross, hasta la cruz. From the cross begins God's work with the church. Desde la cruz comienza el trabajo de Dios con la iglesia. I hope you can see it, but it says here, society grows increasingly evil. Que la sociedad crece más pecaminosa. Okay? Right in the middle of that, dentro de eso, just when society is growing more evil, cuando la sociedad está creciendo aún más mala, en el mismo centro, occurs the rapture. The rapture of the church. We are taken out. Historically, God takes out and saves from judgment those whom he saves. Históricamente, Dios saca de en medio de el juicio venidero aquellos que él ha de salvar. If you notice this light blue, si usted nota este pedazo azul claro, is what is called the tribulation or the great tribulation. Remember, right down the middle is the 3.5 years and three and a half years. En el mismo medio, esto es lo que se le conoce como la tribulación o la gran tribulación. Se divide en dos, 3 años y medio y 3 años y medio. That 7-year period is also called the 70th week of Daniel. Esa semana, esa gran tribulación, es lo que se conoce en profecía como la semana 70 del profeta Daniel. Okay? Because remember, every week is 7 years. Muy bien. Cada semana son 7 años. After the great tribulation, después de la gran tribulación, comes the second coming of Christ. Es cuando viene la segunda venida de Jesucristo. The reason I told you that we're involved in both, la razón que le dije que estamos envueltos en ambos, is because we're involved in the rapture because we go up to be with the Lord. Estamos envueltos en el rapto porque vamos a subir a estar con el Señor. And the Bible states that in the second coming, we descend with the Lord. La Biblia dice que en el, la segunda venida de Cristo, nosotros descendemos con el Señor. All right? If you've never ridden a horse, you'll be riding a horse. Si nunca has montado un caballo, vas a montar un caballo with our Lord. Anybody can tell me, why does it say second coming? ¿Por qué dice segunda venida? What was the first time? His incarnation. It's the theological term. If we're using, if we're growing, if we're learning, if we're going to use those terms that we know, okay, this is en su encarnación. Cuando él vino por primera vez a la tierra, en la ciudad de Belén, esa fue su primera venida. This is important for you to know because he came as a man, and where some Jewish people get tangled, esto es importante saberlo porque donde se enredan algunos judíos is because they could not receive Jesus as Messiah because they expected him to take the throne when he came the first time. No podían aceptar a Cristo como Mesías porque esperaban que Cristo tomara el trono la primera vez. That's why they wanted to make him a king. Por eso lo querían hacer un rey. That's why some of his disciples fought for him, because they thought that he was going to free them from the Roman oppression. Algunos de los discípulos pelearon por él. By the way, I think that's what the conflict with Judas. Creo que ese fue el conflicto con Judas. Judas believed in Jesus. Judas creyó en Jesús. But he believed that Jesus came to sit on the throne. Then, and take Rome out. Judas creyó en Jesús, pero él pensó que él, Jesús, iba a quitar a Roma como poder y él se iba a sentar en el trono. When Jesus starts talking about dying on a cross, Jesús comienza a hablar de morir en una cruz. Every Jewish mind knows if you die on the cross, that's you're condemning yourself, you're cursing yourself. Because the Bible says in the Old Testament, cursed is everyone who dies on the wood, on the tree, en el madero. Maldito el que muere en un madero. I don't believe in you to die on a cross. I believe in you because you're the king. Now take the throne. They didn't understand that, for instance, when the Bible talks about, if you want later on, look at Isaiah 53, Isaiah. It's classic. Isaiah 53. If you get a time, read it. There's a twofold prophecy. Hay una profecía doble en ella. One half speaks that he's coming, but he's coming and he will be despised and hated. Una parte dice que él viene, pero que viene y va a ser odiado, y va a ser despreciado. But it also, if you keep reading, you start understanding the other side to that is that he will also come, and the next time he comes, yo escuché una vez, I heard I guess an atheist, creo que un ateo, I was speaking to him, le estaba hablando, and he told me, listen, if Christ ever comes back, the only thing that's going to happen is that he's going to get crucified again. Si Cristo viene otra vez, lo único que le va a pasar a él es que va a ser crucificado otra vez. I want you to know, he's coming back again, and it's not to die. He's coming back as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen? He's coming back to conquer. Él viene para conquistar, para ser, tomar el trono de David. There is no killing this time. No va a venir a morir esta vez. So there is a... when I was reading this, I wanted to make sure you understood why they call it the second coming. Because the first coming was his incarnation. And he did what he was meant to do. Su primera venida es su encarnación y hizo lo que tenía que hacer. Die. Live like a man. Morir. Vivir como un hombre. But in his second coming, I have something special for you guys. I hope you're excited. Because we're going to go a little deeper. Because, like I said, this is based on somebody that asked me something after the class last week. What's the difference, Pastor? ¿Cuál es la diferencia, Pastor? Me hizo una pregunta la semana pasada una persona después de la clase. I think to myself, if that person's asking, maybe we should all know. Si esa persona está preguntando, quizás todos debemos de saber. How many praise God for that? Amen? I do. Hallelujah. If you notice, after the second, so, this is what I wanted you, or I want you to see.
Esto es lo que quiero que vea.
When the rapture occurs, finally, the Antichrist, say it with me, appears. That's important.
Cuando el rapto ocurre, es cuando aparece, diga conmigo, aparece el anticristo.
So, Obama is the Antichrist, can't be, because he would be there already. And we're still here. Okay, it's Trump then. It can't be because the church is still here. The appearance of the Antichrist is released when the church is gone. After.
La aparición del anticristo aparece. I'm not saying he's not born. No estoy diciendo que no ha nacido. I'm not saying that he's not already a politician. No estoy diciendo que no es un político.
But what I am saying is he will not be revealed in full glory of an antichrist until the church is raised up in the rapture.
No será revelado como en toda su gloria de un anticristo hasta que la iglesia sea levantada.
How many understand? That should give you confidence to know, hey, if I'm still, I spoke to a pastor, he made me laugh. He said, one day I got to church early.
Llegué a la iglesia temprano, and I saw there were no cars. I said, did the rapture?
pasó el rapto? And then I said, no, okay. Because if you grew up in a Pentecostal church, you learn to sometimes question your own salvation.
Si creciste en una iglesia pentecostal, como que uno cuestiona su salvación, and you're like, ugh.
I want to put peace in your heart. Quiero poner paz en su corazón. If you're still on earth, the Antichrist, the rapture has not occurred. And the Antichrist has not appeared.
Si usted todavía está en la tierra, usted no ha experimentado el rapto y todavía el anticristo no ha aparecido.
Amen. Now, the question is, are you saved?
La pregunta es si eres salvo.
See, I don't question my salvation because I know I'm saved.
Yo no cuestiono mi salvación porque sé que soy salvo.
The ones that have to worry are the fakers.
Los que tienen que preocuparse son los que pretenden, los que se hacen.
Just walking to a church doesn't make you saved. Just like walking in a garage doesn't make you a mechanic. Oh, I like that. Tony, write it down. Hallelujah.
Amen. Entrar a una iglesia no te hace salvo, como entrar a un garaje te hace un mecánico.
Anybody can come in a church.
Cualquier persona puede venir a una iglesia.
But when you've surrendered your life and you accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior,
cuando tú has rendido tu vida y has aceptado a Cristo como tu Salvador,
and listen, there's a step. How many believe you are a sinner?
¿Cuántos han creído yo soy un pecador?
How many know Jesus can only save me?
¿Cuántos saben solamente Jesús me puede salvar?
Now the third thing is important. How many believe that's what he did? You were a sinner. And he saved you.
Eras un pecador y te salvó.
I hear people still saying, well, I'm still a sinner. How long have you been serving Christ? 20 years.
Todavía yo soy un pecador. ¿Cuánto tiempo llevas sirviendo a Cristo? 20 años.
Now you may sin.
Usted quizás cometa pecado.
But Christ has nailed to the cross everything that was against you.
Cristo ha clavado en la cruz todo lo que estaba escrito en contra de ti.
And if I'm a child of God, I cannot be dirty now and be a sinner. It reflects on him that his blood had no power to cleanse me. If I take a shower and I'm still declaring I'm dirty, check your soap.
Si yo me baño y todavía estoy declarando que estoy sucio, chequéate el jabón que estás usando. No, es eficaz.
You may walk, I mean, right? Wash it. But Jesus himself said, when Jesus wanted to wash the feet of Peter,
Jesús quería lavarle los pies a Pedro. Peter said, you're not washing my feet. No me vas a lavar los pies.
He says, you don't let me wash your feet. You have no place with me in the kingdom.
Tú no me dejas lavarte los pies. Tú no tienes un sitio conmigo en el reino.
Peter said, wash my head, wash my feet.
He said that. Pedro dijo, lávame el pelo, lávame los pies. Jesus said, take it easy.
What he's saying is there's power in the cleansing power of Jesus Christ.
Hay poder en el poder que limpia de Jesucristo.
How many understand that?
So, the Bible says that in that day,
there will be people left behind.
En ese día van a haber personas que van a quedarse.
But I guarantee none of the ones that are left behind were saved. Are you listening? No man left behind.
Te garantizo que ninguna persona que se queda en el rapto era salvo.
Imposible.
Porque entonces Dios dejó a una persona atrás.
God will not do that. So if you're sure of your salvation, if you're not, you still have time. The rapture hasn't occurred. You're okay.
Si no está seguro, usted busca su salvación, usted declara salvación y tiene tiempo.
But if you're saved, stop questioning if you're saved or not and start declaring that you're saved and begin to do something for Jesus Christ. You know how I know one of the evidence of people that are saved, they want to do things for Jesus.
Personas que son salvos quieren hacer cosas para Jesús.
Now, this is what I want you to say. Once the rapture occurs,
the Antichrist comes out, a la vez que el rapto ocurre, el anticristo sale.
But this is interesting.
Once the second coming occurs, a la vez que la segunda venida
ocurre,
that's when the Antichrist is stopped.
Ahí es cuando se detiene el anticristo.
If you notice, the word here is millennium.
From mil, a thousand.
Okay? It's a thousand years.
There's a trinity that's dealt with here.
Hay una trinidad que se, con la cual se brega aquí.
It's satanic, son satánico. Anybody know which ones they are?
If you don't know. Devil. The Antichrist. Right? And the false.
Es el diablo, el anticristo y el falso profeta. Okay?
That is the satanic trinity.
In that second coming, en esa segunda venida,
these two are dealt with.
Estos dos son eliminados.
Right? But the devil is locked away for a thousand years. 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 Second coming. Segunda venida. The Antichrist. The false prophet. El anticristo. El falso profeta.
By the way, I'm not calling them the Trinity just for nothing.
I'll tell you why. But the devil is put in a pit. El diablo es puesto en un
abismo.
And he's held there for a thousand years. Released again.
Suelto otra vez.
And then finally he meets
his end with the Antichrist and the false prophets. There's a reason I believe God does that. We're not going to get into that. But I want you to know,
the devil is not God. He plays pretend.
El diablo no es Dios. Pero él juega al hacerse como si fuera Dios.
That's his desire. The Bible calls him the God of this world. El Dios. But that's why when we have worship, they put a small g, I try to correct it.
O ponen en español una d pequeña, trato de corregir eso.
Because those are the symbols of pagan gods. And one of them is the devil himself. El diablo mismo. When it calls him a god of this world, it uses it like this. Cuando dice que es el dios de este mundo, lo usa de esta forma. So, as God would use his son, yes?
Como Dios usaría a su hijo,
the devil will use the Antichrist. And as the Holy Spirit opened the way for the Son,
como el Espíritu Santo abrió el camino para el hijo,
the false prophet performs signs and wonders to open the way for the Antichrist. I already see that. So the false prophet is a false Holy Spirit. The Antichrist is a false Jesus. And the devil is a false God.
Okay. That's on purpose. He does that on purpose. Lo hace a propósito. How many get that?
¿Cuánto? Okay. We're not even in the sign. I got to.
But I get excited. Me excito. You know why? I love teaching you guys. Me encanta enseñarle a ustedes. I want you to know what I know. Quiero que ustedes conozcan lo que yo conozco.
If you're online, I hope you're getting a blessing out of this. Si estás en línea, ojalá que usted reciba una bendición.
My desire is for you to meet us here in the house of God. Mi deseo es que se encuentre aquí en la casa de Dios. There's something that happens when you get dressed and you come into the house. Hay algo que ocurre cuando usted se viste y llega a la casa de Dios. Because you can talk to your girlfriend on the phone all the time.
Usted le puede hablar a la novia por el teléfono tantas veces until she says, hey, when are you coming to visit me? ¿Cuándo tú vienes a visitarme? You know, because person, it says a lot. Here we go. Rapture and the second coming contrasted. El rapto y la segunda venida en contraste. And I like this. No me gusta. I think I need to stick this one.
in the rapture, and in the second coming.
En el rapto, en la segunda venida. Let's see if I can do it quickly.
In the rapture, could return at any moment.
En el rapto, Cristo puede regresar en cualquier momento.
In the second coming, en la segunda venida, following timed events.
Hay eventos que él está siguiendo.
And it's true. Okay? In the rapture, don't know the time. In the second coming, 3.5 years after the abomination of desolation.
En el rapto no se conoce el tiempo. En la segunda venida, 3 años y medio después de la desolación, de la abominación.
Which is what prophetically many people believe, that the Antichrist comes in to the temple in Jerusalem,
into the Holy of Holies,
and he sits. For a Jewish person, that's
se cree que la desolación de abominación es que el anticristo entra al templo que se va a estar haciendo en Jerusalén y entra en el lugar santísimo y se sienta allí,
and he requires worship.
Y requiere adoración.
So, imagine that. Okay. Rapture, el rapto, earth, not judged.
La tierra no juzgada,
earth is judged.
La tierra es juzgada.
Rapture, translated saints go to heaven.
Los santos del Señor van al cielo.
I know we have, I learned my lesson the time I mentioned saints. And there's some Catholics that believe saints are something else. Right? The Bible calls us saints. If you're washed in the blood, we are saints. We're not perfect, but we're saints. How many understand?
Nosotros somos los santos del Señor, y yo conozco mi error, que hay personas que vienen quizás de un trasfondo católico que saben que un santo es otra cosa. La Iglesia Católica declara que esta persona es santa y eso es un santo. Yo no soy un santo. Mentira del diablo. Si tú eres salvo, la Biblia nos llama a nosotros los santos del Señor. No porque somos perfectos. Santo significa separado para Dios.
You're separate for God. Okay, so in the rapture, the translated saints go to heaven. Los santos son trasladados al cielo. In the second coming, en la segunda venida, translated saints return
to earth.
To earth.
You want to read about that, Revelation 19. Okay.
Si quieres leer sobre eso, Revelación 19. Aquí los santos que son trasladados y regresan a la tierra. Here, rapture is a mystery. Rapto es un misterio. That's what the Apostle Paul says. El Apostle Pablo dice eso. Here, the second coming is predicted often,
even in the Old Testament.
Aquí, la segunda venida es predicho muchas veces en el Antiguo Testamento. Before, here, the rapture before the day of wrath, antes del día del juicio, es el rapto. Here, concluding the day of wrath. Aquí, ya terminando el día del juicio. Here, no reference to Satan in the rapture.
No hay referencia a Satanás en el rapto.
Here, Satan, it says that he is bound. Aquí dice que Satanás es atado.
One commentary I always have in my notes is that it interests me that the Bible says and he sent an angel to bind Satan. You know why that's important to me? Dice que Dios envió a Satanás. I would have said, and he sent the great archangel Gabriel. Right?
Yo hubiera dicho, mandó el arcángel Gabriel, and boom, boom, boom.
He sent an angel, like a little corporal.
Come on.
Come on.
You know why? Because it's not the power of the angel. It's the word that he's carrying.
My God, that's good.
No es el poder del ángel que ata a Satanás. Es que él tiene una palabra del Dios Altísimo que dice, tú te sometes. Te sometes a un ángel cualquiera, por así decir. Es que no hay un ángel cualquiera, pero
you understand that. That I see me.
I don't have a power. I don't have an authority. But all the power I have and all the authority I have is because I carry the name of Jesus Christ. My God.
Yo no tengo poder ni autoridad, pero el poder y autoridad que tengo Lo tengo porque cargo el nombre de Jesucristo. When I have that name, demons have to tremble and they hold themselves to that name. Yo tengo ese nombre y los demonios se tiemblan y tienen que sujetarse a ese. Man, I wish the church would use the name of Jesus. Ojalá. I think that's why Hollywood uses it so much to curse. So that we won't find meaning. Por eso yo creo que Hollywood lo usa tanto para maldecir. Para que nosotros como que ya no le tengamos tanto valor. But the world can use it all they want. They have no power. But when a child of God says Jesus, all heaven moves and all hell trembles. Because a child of God is calling the name. How many believe that? Amen. Cuando un hijo de Dios clama el nombre de Jesús, se mueve el cielo y tiembla el infierno. Porque un hijo está llamando ese nombre. I would guarantee, I would tell you, you're having a bad day, get yourself in a bathroom, lock yourself. You don't have to scream, just say Jesus, 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 Jesus. And know what that means. Métete en un baño, métete, escóndete, y di ese nombre. You can't hide, just under your breath, say the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. How many say amen? Why don't we say Jesus, amen, Jesus. El nombre de Jesús, hallelujah. I believe it's Sunday, hallelujah. He comes for his own bride in the rapture. En su rapto, él viene a buscar su novia. In the second coming, he comes with his own bride. En la segunda venida, viene con su novia. Everybody saw the difference? Okay. Here he comes for, here he comes with. Aquí viene por, aquí viene con. Here, the second coming, he comes in the air. That's very important. Aquí en el, perdón, I said second coming, in the rapture. En el rapto, él viene en el aire. Here he comes and he touches the earth, the Bible says. He touches, in fact, he places a geographical point out, he places his foot on the Mount of Olives. The Bible says. La Biblia dice que él pone su pie sobre el monte de los olivos. So él toca la tierra en la segunda venida. I'm gonna show you something. It's because the rapture is not to be seen by everyone. But the second coming, CNN, Fox News, everybody's going to see this. It's for everyone. And they're going to see, the Bible says, the one that was pierced. Dice que van a ver al que fue traspasado. So the riddle is, what is there in heaven that was made by man? And it's the wounds of Jesus. ¿Qué hay en el cielo que fue creado por el hombre? Y es las heridas de Jesús. They're still there today. All right. In the rapture, he comes for believers only. How many say amen? En el rapto viene solamente para los creyentes. In the second coming, his return will impact all people. That's important. In the rapture, only his own will see him. En el rapto solamente los suyos lo verán. In the second coming, every eye will see him. En la segunda venida, todo ojo le verá. So if you hear somebody say, en el rapto todo ojo le verá, that's not true. They're mixing two. If they say, oh, in the rapture every eye is going to see him, they're mixing it. That's the second coming reference. Okay. In the rapture, tribulation begins. En el rapto, la tribulación comienza. In the second coming, the millennial kingdom begins. En la segunda venida comienza el reino millennial. And the last one in the rapture is before the day of the wrath. El rapto es antes del día del juicio. In the second coming, it is concluding the day of the wrath. En la segunda venida es concluyendo el día de la ira. Quickly, rapture and second coming. Second Thessalonians, by the way, is fantastic.
for the rapture. Okay? By the way, the word rapture, if you look for it in the concordance, it doesn't appear.
La palabra rapto en una concordancia no aparece.
The word rapture does not appear in the Bible. Many people that do not believe in the rapture will say, yeah, the word rapture doesn't appear in the Bible. Why do you believe in it?
¿Por qué usted cree en la Biblia, en el rapto si la Biblia no habla del rapto?
Your answer can be, the Bible doesn't mention the word Trinity, but it exists.
Que la Biblia no menciona ninguna vez la palabra Trinidad, pero existe la Trinidad.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
El Padre, Hijo, y el Espíritu Santo.
So even though it doesn't mention rapture, it mentions snatch.
Arrebatamiento.
That's the Greek word for rapture.
Esa es la palabra griega para la palabra rapto.
All right? So, 1 Thessalonians 4, Primera de Tesalonicense 4, rapture appears. Second, in the second coming, Revelation 19, he returns. Christ returns. Number one, Christ appears in the rapture. Christ appears in the heavens. Número uno, en el rapto, Cristo aparece en los cielos. Number two, he is the deliverer. En número dos, él es el libertador. Number three, it is for the church, the rapture. Número tres, es por la iglesia, el rapto. Number four, he has love and compassion. Número cuatro, tiene amor y compasión in the rapture, en el rapto. Last one, it is for the bridegroom. Es para el novio. O sea, aparece como el novio. He is the bridegroom. In the rapture, en el rapto. Second coming, he returns to earth. A la tierra. Number two, he is the warrior. Número dos, es el guerrero. Number three, he is with the church. Él es con la iglesia. Number four, he comes with wrath and vengeance. Él viene con ira y venganza. And number five, he is presented as the King of Kings. En el número cinco, aparece como el rey de reyes. How many say amen? This is, I brought this here because if you want to take a picture, I'm not going to read these verses. No way, Jose. Yo no voy a leer estos versos. But I thought, in fact, I was kind of surprised that so many of them made a reference to the rapture.
Como que me sorprendí un poco que habían tantos que hacían referencia al rapto.
These are all for the second coming.
Estos son para el rapto. Estos son para la segunda venida.
If you're reading that, if you're writing that, any questions there? Hay pregunta. Dígame.
En el principio del milenio, Satanás es atado, dice la Biblia, por los mil años, y luego suelto al final de, y van a haber personas, según la Biblia en el Antiguo Testamento, que van a nacer durante el milenio. Pero Satanás, cuando es soltado, engaña a toda esa gente que han vivido durante mil años.
That teaches us something. That Satan is bound and put away for 1,000 years, the millennium. He is released, and the Bible says that he tricks the people, deceives. Thank you. He deceives those that are living during that time. That says something. So dice algo. If there wasn't sin in the world, si no hubiera pecado en el mundo, if the devil didn't exist, si el diablo no existiera, the thing is, for 1,000 years, there's nothing. And all of a sudden, that seed is still there. He comes, he deceives everyone there. And Christ finally executes judgment. And then what's known as the eternal reign of Christ, that has no end, begins. Entonces, el reino eterno de Cristo comienza. By the way, that's where the Bible finishes. But I don't think history finishes. Get it?
Para mí es un engaño de persona creer que lo último en Revelación es donde termina la historia.
These people that believe that we're going to heaven and we're going to be flying around with harps and we have nothing to do. Hay personas que creen que vamos a estar en el cielo con arpa y no tenemos nada que hacer.
In fact, there's people that say, I'd rather go to hell where there's going to be a party than go to heaven that's going to be so boring, because there's a misconception.
Hay una mal concepto. Prefiero ir al infierno donde va a haber una fiesta todos los días y van a haber mujeres y drogas y esto y lo otro, que irme al cielo, eso va a estar tan aburrido. Eso es un malentendido.
Heaven is going to be the most glorious. What your eye has never seen.
Lo que tu ojo nunca ha visto. Ears never heard. Tu oído nunca.
And then there is the mandate on your life. Y luego el mandato sobre tu vida.
You think Christ saved you just to save you? He saved you because he loves you. And he saves you now because he has a purpose for your life.
Cristo te salva porque te ama y tiene un propósito por tu vida.
And some of that purpose is going to be revealed in the eternal kingdom.
En el reino eterno.
If he tells Tony, I need you to take care of this galaxy. There's another people that I need to reach with the gospel. I'm not sending my son.
My God. Are you listening to me?
I'm not sending one son. Now I'm sending millions of sons and daughters with the message of salvation. What if that's the plan?
Because remember, there are galaxies. It's proven.
Hay galaxias.
Es probado.
God is a God of purpose.
Why would he create something we can't reach?
¿Por qué crear algo que no podemos alcanzar?
Aquí.
And by the way, I told that person last week, le dije a la persona la semana pasada,
there's a reason why, since so far ago, there's always been attention to aliens.
Hay una razón por qué siempre ha habido una atención a los extraterrestres.
I believe when the rapture occurs, because the person told me, but when the rapture occurs, people are going to believe.
The Bible says that there's going to be more people that are not going to believe.
That blows your mind.
Millions of people disappear. You gotta believe, right?
That it's because I bet, my opinion, there's gonna be a rumor saying, you see, those aliens
se llevaron esta gente, desaparecieron. Y esto, o sea, en vez de darle gloria a Dios, dice la Biblia dice que tienen más coraje contra Dios.
So if you think a person, there's going to be a small group of people that have heard the gospel but never gave their life to Christ.
Un grupo pequeño de personas que escucharon el mensaje, nunca dieron su vida a Cristo.
And those, a small group, un grupo pequeño, that when the rapture occurs, even if CNN says they're aliens, in their heart they're going to be like, nope, my grandmother told me what this is.
Mi abuelita me dijo lo que era esto.
There's no aliens.
This is the rapture of the church, and I'm left behind. The only way the Bible says that these people can be saved is now that they have to give their life.
The Bible speaks of decapitation.
Dar su vida. Ser decapitado.
By the way, if it's just that, kind of easy.
Si es eso, un momento y ya.
But imagine if it's torture first.
Si es tortura primero,
deny Christ.
Niega a Cristo.
I got this thing in my lip. I think I bit my lip.
Me mordí el labio.
Minister,
me duele tanto.
And when I go like this, at that, by mistake,
veo la mona. So I can look at la mona.
I'm like, I feel it in my heart.
That's just that.
Imagine pulling nails.
Deny Christ.
Niega a Cristo.
We're so weak. You know why? Right now, we're strong.
If somebody comes in, who denies Christ?
We'll be like, no, we're not denying Christ.
We're going to die. But you know what gives us the valor to do that? The Holy Spirit.
El Espíritu Santo nos da el valor.
But the Spirit is not there dealing with us in after the rapture.
Ya el Espíritu no está bregando con la iglesia después del rapto.
Now he's concentrated on Israel.
Ahora está concentrado con Israel.
So what's going to give you the courage if you're left behind to give your life for Christ when you couldn't even get up at 10 in the morning for service?
With the Holy Spirit. I threw that there because it's real.
Porque nosotros en lo mínimo es un esfuerzo y eso es con el Espíritu Santo. Levantarnos a las 10 de la mañana para llegar a la iglesia, lo pensamos tanto. Y lo calculamos y venir a los miércoles, a la oración los martes. Yeah. Y eso es con el Espíritu Santo. Pero somos bravos. Because we say, oh, I'll give my life for Christ. If I see the whole church go, I'm going to give my life. If my wife leaves, I'm giving my life for Christ. Because I know what it was.
You say that. Tú dices eso. But when the torture starts, by the way, the Bible says once you're sealed with 666, that can never be taken back.
Amen.
You've canceled your right. Even if you die for Christ, it's done because you receive the seal of the beast.
Recibiste el sello de la bestia.
By the way, you say, how can it be 666 for everyone? But it's six digits of six. That sounds like a social security. And look how many million people are there.
Seis dígitos de seis.
Para cada persona, either in the forehead or the right hand. Once that goes on, you can't say, take that back. I want to give my life for Christ. You've received the seal of the beast. La señal.
El sello de la bestia.
No se puede regresar. So what I'm saying to you is, now we're living in grace. Let's live for Jesus Christ. Because I know I can't die for Jesus Christ if I'm left behind without the help of the Holy Spirit. I'm doomed. Me voy a perder.
Sin la ayuda del Espíritu Santo, me pierdo.
¿Cuántos dicen amén?
That's not meant to scare you. That's meant to make you stronger in your faith. That's meant to say, you know what? I was doubting, but now I believe. Aleluya, yo creo eso. Esto no es para asustarte. Esto es para afirmarte en la fe. Para que tú tengas una fe tan fuerte que si estabas tambaleando, tú digas, no. Yo antes dudaba, pero ahora yo creo. Y creo con todo mi corazón. So, para los hispanos, Acts, Hechos, right? Where you see Acts and Hechos. Anything else here? Zachariah.
I think everything else you can understand. Si necesita una foto. Me parece que ese también está en Facebook. I think that's in Facebook, yeah? Okay, thank you. That's okay. I haven't been on it. I just put that up and got on. I hit you in my mouth.
Mira, ahora estamos comenzando.
Qué bueno.
Amen.
What time is it?
Eight. Hallelujah.
What other, this is where we stopped. Aquí fue donde nos detuvimos. Why did I insert it there? ¿Por qué lo puse allí? Because the next questions kind of have to do, guess what, with the second coming. Not the rapture. The second coming.
Algunas de las preguntas hacen como referencia a la segunda venida, no al rapto, a la segunda venida.
What other signs of the last days does the Bible mention?
¿Cuáles son las otras señales de los últimos días que menciona la Biblia?
It's in the Bible, está en la Biblia. Luke 21, 25 through 26. Lucas 21, verso 25, 26. I have it in English and Spanish here. Lo tengo en inglés y en español. And there will be strange signs in the sun, moon, and stars. And here on earth, the nations will be in turmoil, perplexed by the roaring seas and strange tides. Everybody emphasize the word strange. Strange, okay?
Y habrán señales extrañas en el sol, en la luna, y en las estrellas. Y aquí en la tierra, las naciones del mundo estarán en caos, perpleja por los mares rugientes, y las mareas extrañas.
I find that there, biblically, there's going to be a lot of activity in the ocean. Remember, there's more water than land on the earth.
Veo que proféticamente va a haber mucha actividad en los océanos, en el agua, en el mar. Y recuerde que hay más agua que tierra en el globo terráqueo.
Right? So, understanding that,
How many are starting to see a rise in tsunamis? Hay un aumento en tsunami. There's more activities that are occurring. Hay más actividades. Things that people, even that storm that hit that category 4, that hit, where was it? Texas? Was it? Mexico City. They had never seen one in history, category 4. Nunca en una categoría 4, nunca habían visto en la historia. Through the Gulf of Mexico. Never seen that before. Nunca han visto eso. That's important. You know why that's important? Paul never saw it. Pablo nunca lo vio. We're seeing it. So that means historically, think about it biblically. Piense esto bíblicamente. Our eyes are seeing what others have never seen. So we're seeing that we're coming closer to an end, to what the Bible is saying. Que nuestros ojos están viendo cosas que otros nunca han visto y que estamos viendo que estamos más cerca del final. The end can be another 100 years. You and I will be dead, but we're closer to the end. It's still that way. El final puede ser otros 100 años. Pero es el final y tú y yo vamos a estar muertos. We'll be part of the dead in Christ that rise. Nosotros seremos parte entonces de los muertos en Cristo que resucitarán primero. All right, in the rapture. And I want you to also notice the word strange signs. Quiero que también vean la palabra, habrán señales extrañas. And did you read the last part of that verse? It says, strange tides. Also, al final del verso 25 también dice, y mareas extrañas. We don't even know what that means. Nosotros ni entendemos lo que eso significa. If it's going in a way that people cannot predict, si está yendo en una forma que no se puede predecir, if it reacts in a different way, si está reaccionando, but it's going to be strange. What it's telling us is it's not going to be something that we're common to. Que no será algo que somos muy asociado o que es algo común. If you see a falling star, we've seen that. Tú ves una estrella cayendo, usted ha visto eso. You start seeing stars hitting Earth all over the place. That's strange. You see something happening, an eclipse in the sun, we've seen that. Si usted ve un eclipse en el sol, eso se ha visto. If you see something happening in the sun, si usted comienza a ver cosas, señales en el sol mismo, and then it says the moon, y luego la luna. Now we're starting to see something out of the ordinary. Estamos viendo algo fuera. So what I'm talking to you is signs. When you start seeing those signs, you know something's up. So we're close. Cuando ves esas señales, estamos cerca. Verse 26, el verso 26. Let me drink some water from my fancy cup. Este fue un regalo del domingo. Thank you so much. We appreciate everything. Verso 26, verse 26. People will be terrified at what they see coming upon the earth, for the powers in the heavens will be shaken. La gente quedará aterrada de lo que verán venir sobre la tierra, porque los poderes de los cielos serán sacudidos. What's important there is that people will panic and be terrified. Make sure you're not panicked. You're not terrified. If this is from the second coming, si esto de la segunda venida, we don't have to worry. We're with the Lord. Estamos con el Señor. But for the signs that will be here, don't lose your mind. Just because everybody else is nervous, don't get nervous. Porque todos los demás están nerviosos. You know when it's hard? When it's your family, right? And they bring it to you home. Cuando es tu familia y te lo traen a la casa. ¿Viste las noticias? Did you see the news? Oh my goodness. Did you see what happened over there and over here? ¿Viste lo que pasó? ¿Viste? You saw the moon? You saw this? And if you're not careful, and if you're not prayerful, I'm going to end with that, by the way. Si no eres, no tienes cuidado y no estás orando, voy a terminar con eso. Prayer will center you. La oración te causa que tú estés centralizado. I don't know about you, but when I pray, it's like taking a calming pill. Cuando yo oro, es como que tomo una pastillita de un calmante.
I combine that with the word of God. Oh my goodness. I feel the peace of God.
Yo combino la oración con la palabra y siento la paz de Dios.
But I'll tell you, the enemy will always try to steal your peace.
El enemigo siempre trata de robarte la paz.
And he doesn't come with horns and a tail. He'll sometimes come as mommy or daddy or the daughter or the son.
No viene con cuernos y un rabo. Algunas veces viene como un familiar, mami, papi, los hijos.
And they try to afflict your peace.
You gotta be at peace.
Be calm. Be calm.
How many remember when the disciples were in the boat with Jesus?
I said with Jesus.
I said with Jesus.
That's important, right?
It's like Jesus is with you.
Amen?
He's not outside of you. He's with you.
Cristo está contigo. A través del Espíritu Santo, Él vive dentro de ti.
How many say amen?
And when the waves, there were waves and there were winds, había viento, había marea, había todo eso, era cierto.
But Jesus kind of rebuked them because when they woke him up, they said, don't you care? We're going to die. Don't you care?
Vamos a morir, no te importa.
How many know Jesus cares?
Amen. ¿Cuántos saben que Jesús sí le importa?
Amen. But the thing that make us nervous don't make God nervous.
Las cosas que nos hacen nerviosos a nosotros no hacen a Dios nervioso.
And the Bible says that you have the mind of Christ.
And that I place my hand.
Y que yo tengo la mente de Cristo.
And that I have the power to say no to all the negative stuff and all the bad news and the fake news.
Y tengo el poder de decirle que no a las cosas malas y negativas y noticias falsas.
No, no, no. I'm going to believe the word of God.
Voy a creer la palabra de Dios.
Sister, come on down. Thank you. You reminded me.
Gracias.
La ofrenda, if you have it.
I don't come on prayer, I give it today,
today's and yesterday.
That way I can feel like I'm still blessing the church.
Si no vengo a un servicio de oración, doy el de ayer y el de hoy para sentir que sigo bendiciendo la iglesia.
I'm just testifying. If you want to do the same, God bless you.
Estoy testificando. Si quieres hacer lo mismo,
Dios te bendiga. And by the way, you don't have to. No lo tienes que hacer.
God is good.
Quick, Virginia, your testimonies.
Let me.
Did I finish? Right?
Yes, I did. Go ahead. Go.
Well, I want to give God thanks because, like you said, preaching to the family is hard. Yesterday, I had a 3-hour MRI, and it was a rough day yesterday, and I still made it to Tuesday prayer.
Amen.
Uh-huh. It was. I made it 8 minutes later, but I had left. But I needed to come yesterday. I didn't tell nobody I was getting an MRI. Nobody knew. Well, I'll make it short.
Thank you.
Yesterday, I had a 3-hour MRI.
Amen.
I went in at 8:20. When I got out of here, I got out at midnight. I had pain, severe pain. And I still have severe pain, but I'm in victory because the pain does not stop who I am as a Christian.
Amen.
I'm getting closer in the Word.
I'm praying more. I'm proclaiming the promises that He promised me and my family.
Amen.
And no pain. Because God's greatest pain, He took to the cross. And I thank God for that perfect gift. I'm like the Pastor Hernandez Sunday said, well, I'm a crybaby before God because I know the presence of the Holy Spirit is with me. And I'm sorry if I'm a little emotional. I'm not. I'm trying to be strong.
No.
I work today. Everyone is negative, and I still smile. I still praise the Lord. I say, God bless you. Have a blessed day. Have a blessed week. And they was telling me, I went from the MRI last night. I didn't go to sleep till 4. I woke up at 7. I took my daughter to college. I went to the chiropractor because I know that God has him as a purpose in my life. And He helped adjust me, and I felt better, even though I still had the pain from my head. I've been burning from my head all the way down to my feet. But I know even in that, God has a purpose, because the Holy Spirit is with me. He's bigger, como un poderoso gigante, that's how He is. So I give God thanks, I'm not perfect. I make mistakes. I pray to God. I ask for forgiveness every day. But they were saying, you're disabled, and you come to be just to work. I said, I have God. I had to walk in the freezer and stay in the freezer and load cheese for the burning to go down. But when I got out, the burning was still there. I have faith. I believe my healing. I believe my healing 12 years ago when I got hit by that tractor trailer, and I will still say it. People can have pity on me. I don't take your pity because it isn't about pity. It's about God. I give God thanks. And I'm sorry I'm taking so long. I'll make it short. The young people were saying, why don't you, curse? And I'm like, kidding me? God is my everything. I will never. You need to control your voice, and you need to know that God is good. Because they want to commit suicide, and I'm praying for them. They're young. They're 19, 20, 21 years old. But I come against all suicide. I come against all depression. I come against all that the enemy is trying to take, but he's under my feet. I know it. And I may not have feeling in my left side, but if for the glory of God, I'm standing, I'm moving, and it's God's will. It's not mine. It's not mine.
God is good, amen. Quickly, verse, we're still finishing it. Talk of peace and safety are a sign of the last days. Remember that. Cuando empiecen a hablar sobre la paz y seguridad, eso es señal de los últimos días. Now, that's been happening for many, many decades. Eso estaba pasando por muchas décadas. But it's happening more and more. Está pasando más y más. So that's a big sign that's revealed in Scripture. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 2 through 3. Primera de Tesalonicenses, capítulo 5, verso 2 al 3. Let's see. It says, for you know quite well that the day of the Lord's return will come unexpectedly like a thief in the night. Pues ustedes saben muy bien que el día del regreso del Señor llegará inesperadamente como un ladrón en la noche. When people are saying everything is peaceful and secure, then disaster will fall on them as suddenly as a pregnant woman's labor pain begin. And there will be no escape. Cuando la gente esté diciendo, todo está tranquilo y seguro, entonces le caerá encima la catástrofe tan repentinamente como le vinieron los dolores de parto a una mujer embarazada y no habrá escapatoria. So, always remember that the word of God says that it will be like a thief in the night. Siempre recuerde que la Biblia dice que será como un ladrón en la noche. He's not coming as a thief in the night. In other words, él no viene siendo un ladrón. A thief comes to take what doesn't belong to him. Un ladrón coge lo que no le pertenece. This reference is just to say that when you do not expect it, that's when it will happen. Esta referencia es simplemente para enseñar que cuando usted no lo esté esperando, es cuando va a ocurrir. And I want you to know that's the rapture is like that. El rapto será así. We can be here one moment, and the Bible says, in a blink of an eye. Podemos estar aquí un momento, y la Biblia dice que en un abrir y cerrar de ojo. When you read that in the original Greek, cuando usted lee eso en el griego original, it's not this. It's not this. Can you see me? Watch. It's not that. No es esto. It's not that. Have you ever been scared, Minister Mari? Yeah. Like somebody, boom! Así, cuando alguien te... And have, do you know that when you get startled, you blink? Cuando usted se asusta, usted palpa. It is so much faster than a regular blinking. Es tan rápido, más rápido que el palpadear así regular. It's just, well, guess what? That's the one that the Bible is saying.
That close and opening of an eye. Eso es abrir y cerrar de ojo. That one, the one of a startle, el de un susto. Because we'll be walking and all of a sudden we'll be in his glory. Estaremos caminando y de un momento estaremos en su gloria. We will be meeting the Lord in the sky. This is not a fable. Esto no es una fábula. This is, you know why I believe it? I read something that always impacted me since my youth. Leí algo que tanto me impactó en mi juventud, and it was Genesis 1:1. What does it say? Finish it. In the beginning, God. In the beginning. If you don't know that verse, number one, shame on you. And number two, you need to go downstairs to be with the children and learn the verse. Learn the verse. Si usted no lo conoce, qué pena, y debe de irse con los niños y debe de saber el texto. No, but the text, the first verse of the Bible, Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. En el principio, creó Dios los cielos y la tierra. The reason that's important, la razón que eso es importante, and I think it was Josh McDowell, creo que fue Josh McDowell that said it. He said, if you can believe Genesis 1:1, you can believe the whole Bible. When I was a young man, I said, that's true. Si usted puede creer el primer verso de la Biblia, usted puede creer toda la Biblia. Think about that. Think about that. If God created heaven and earth, did he create a flood? Where Noah had to make a boat? Si él creó el cielo y la tierra, creó, did he send a great fish to swallow Jonah? Mandó a un Jonah, un gran pez, a que se tragara Jonah. Did he resurrect from the dead in 3 days? Resucitó. Do you see what I'm saying to you? So when you follow the line of scripture and you see truth, cuando sigues la línea de la escritura y ves verdad, well, if Jesus says he's coming back for a church and he's going to rapture us and it's going to be in a blink of an eye, if God said it, I believe it. Si Dios lo dijo, yo lo creo. Porque todo lo demás que lo dijo. Now, if the God that we serve has lied to us, and every time we're just holding on to lie after lie, I would be with you saying, I don't know about this. Yo no sé de esto. The God I serve, everything he said has come to pass. Todo lo que Dios ha dicho ha pasado. So praise God for that. Gloria a Dios por eso. So, and it's going to be like a pregnant woman, by the way. If you're a married man, that's the hardest part for us. Because you can't do anything about it. Un hombre, un esposo, cuando ve a su esposa, que le da ese dolor y tú no puedes hacer nada. My daughter was in labor. I was in the room. I just started rocking. And I don't care who it was that was talking to me. I wasn't responding. Yo no estaba respondiendo. Yo me estaba meciendo. Because to see my little girl in so much pain, and you can't do anything about it. Tanto dolor, y tú no puedes hacer nada. Because it has to pass. It has to go through its process. Tiene que pasar y tiene que pasar por su proceso. But it's going to be just like when that wife goes, oh, I felt something. You know that it's, she didn't give birth, but it's the beginning. No dio a luz, pero es el principio de dolores. Well, that's what it's going to be when people say, well, peace and security. We're secure. Tenemos paz. We build the wall. Pusimos la pared. That's not me for it or against it. I'm not saying that. No estoy en contra o a favor de la pared. No estoy diciendo eso. But when we were trying to create an atmosphere of security, estamos tratando de crear una atmósfera de seguridad. And that goes right perfectly with what God says. That when we say we're secure and we're safe, that's when end comes. Que cuando digamos que estamos seguros y estamos protegidos, ahí es donde viene el fin. The coming of the Antichrist, la venida del anticristo, is a sign of the end. It's in the Bible. La venida del anticristo es una señal del final, está en la Biblia. First John, which is the epistle of John, la epístola de Juan, primera de Juan, chapter 2, verse 18, capítulo 2, verso 18, that an epistle is a letter, la epístola es una carta, that is a letter, it's not the gospel. And look at what it says. Mire lo que dice. Dear children, that means that God is talking to us, okay? We're the church. Que Dios nos está hablando a nosotros, que somos sus hijos. Dear children, the last hour is here. I calculated if 1 week prophetic language is 7 years, si una semana profética son 7 años, then how much is 1 hour? It's the equivalent of a prophetic 15 minutes. That's just me trying to blow my own mind. Hallelujah. I actually made that calculation. Amazing. Dear children, the last hour is here. You have heard that the Antichrist is coming. That's important. And already many such Antichrists have appeared. From this, we know that the last hour has come. Queridos hijos, llegó la última hora. Ustedes han oído que el anticristo viene, y ya han surgido muchos anticristos, por eso sabemos que la última hora ha llegado. If John said that 2,000 years ago, how much closer are we now? You shouldn't be thinking, well, it's a long time, I guess it's not going to happen. No, it's going to happen now even closer. No debes de pensar, bueno, no ha pasado en 2,000 años, no. No va a pasar, no, debes de estar pensando, ahora estamos más cerca que nunca. Now, I want you to see what I taught you before. Quiero que vea lo que le enseñé anteriormente, the difference of the, el, and let's say many, mucho. Meaning, this is one of those verses, este es uno de esos versos, that teach a difference. The Antichrist, when it says the Antichrist, he's talking about the one here in the Trinity. Cuando habla de el Anticristo, está hablando de este, el de la Trinidad Satánica. If you read it again, it says, children, you have heard the hours here. You have heard that the Antichrist, that's very specific, que el Anticristo, muy específico. And then it continues saying, many such Antichrists have appeared. Y luego continúa diciendo, y han surgido muchos Anticristos. Because I taught you that Antichrist doesn't only, it means two things. Anticristo significa dos cosas, to be like Christ and to be against Christ. El ser como Cristo y el ser en contra de Cristo. The Antichrist has those two things. He wants to be just as Christ and he is against Christ. El Anticristo tiene ambas cosas. Él quiere ser como Cristo y está en contra de Cristo. But listen to this. John is also revealing that there are people that act like Antichrist. That's what he means. También él está revelando que hay personas que actúan como anticristos. So, anybody you know, anybody you hear that is against Christ is a anti-Christ. Cualquier persona que usted conoce o cualquier persona que usted ha escuchado que es en contra de Cristo es un anticristo. Anyone you hear that says, I am Christ, cualquier persona que usted oye que diga, yo soy Cristo, he is a Antichrist. Is he the Antichrist? No, because I'm still on earth. When I go in the rapture, the Antichrist will appear. And I told you, Hitler will be nothing compared to him. Hitler será nada en comparación a él. He will be infused with all the power of Satan. Él será poseído completamente, no por un demonio, por todo el poder de Satanás.
Do you know that the only one in scripture that says that Satan entered him, not a demon, like the demonized man, no un demonio como el hombre galareno que era demoniado por demonio, no, Judas, Judas, the Bible says that Satan entered him. Imagine, that's how much possession you needed to betray the Son of God. That Satan himself said, I'll take care of this one.
Satanás dijo, yo me tengo que encargar de este porque se necesita mi poder para traicionar al Señor. Yo quiero estar seguro. And he still failed.
Christ died on the cross and resurrected on the third day.
Cristo murió en la cruz y resucitó el tercer día.
But another person possessed by him will be the Antichrist.
Otro poseído por él será el Anticristo.
What are the people, what are people to do when they see these things taking place?
¿Qué han de hacer las personas cuando vean estas cosas suceder?
It's in the Bible, Matthew 24, 42 through 44.
¿Qué han de hacer las personas cuando vean estas señales? Mateo, está en la Biblia, Mateo 24, 42 al 44.
I love this one, and I think it's a good one to end.
Este es bueno, y es bueno para terminar con este verso.
Listen, it says, so you too must keep what? Watch. That's the first thing to do. What do I do? Keep watch. What are you watching for? Signs. Signs. You're looking. This is a study on signs. What's the use of me taking all this time? What is it, Brother Cisco? Class number five? Course number five. Five classes dedicated to this. You leave here and you live life without watching out for the signs.
Sale de aquí, esta es la clase número, el curso número 5. Usted sale de aquí sin mirar las señales.
Now you should live life knowing, okay, that's in the Bible.
Eso está en la Biblia. I'm not going to be worried. God tells me I have peace. No me voy a preocupar. Dios me dice que tengo paz.
That's supposed to happen. Praise God for that.
Eso está supuesto pasar. Gloria a Dios por eso. You see?
I'll tell you even more. Even what happened in Pittsburgh, we studied that. That there will be people haters of God.
La semana pasada estudiamos que habrán gente que odien a Dios.
Only a person with hate in his heart can do that.
Solamente una persona con odio en el corazón puede hacer tal cosa.
We're studying it. That's a sign. Es una señal. But you have to watch. Tienes que velar. For you do not know what day your Lord is coming.
Así que ustedes deben... También deben estar alerta, porque no saben qué día vendrá su Señor.
Everybody understand? Jesus is talking. Jesús está hablando. You hear anybody, I don't care who it is, on TBN, on Daystar. God spoke to me and told me the day of his coming. Don't believe it.
Dios me habló y me dijo el día de su venida.
Jesus is talking here. And he says, no, it says, you do not know the day of your Lord's coming.
Que usted no conoce, ustedes también estén alerta porque no saben qué día vendrá su Señor.
Understand this. If a homeowner, I love this. If a homeowner knew exactly when a burglar was coming, we would keep watch and not permit his house to be broken into.
Entiendan lo siguiente. Si el dueño de una casa supiera exactamente a qué hora viene un ladrón, se mantendría alerta y no dejaría que asaltara su casa.
Cisco, he's coming at 3 in the morning tonight. You're going right now. You're going home. Josie, put some coffee on. No one's going to bed here.
Si Cisco sabe que a las 3 llega el ladrón, él le dice a la esposa, pon café, nadie se va a dormir, que ya yo sé que a las 3 él viene. Y él mismo está diciendo, estoy armado, estoy preparado. I'm locked and loaded, I'm ready to go. That's right. You should be. I would think that's ignorance if you know a person tells you, I'll be there at 3, and you go to sleep. Esa ignorancia que te alguien que un pillo, para decírselo así, no un ladrón, un pillo. Un pillo te dice a ti, vengo a las 3, y tú coges y te acuestas a las 8. Eso es ignorancia. Porque tú debes de estar velando. But guess what? This in the spiritual is just that. We live our Christian life half awake and half asleep. Vivimos nuestra vida cristiana medio despierto y medio dormido. Como abobado. Like we're dumbfounded. Like we don't understand. And these signs should wake us up. Estas señales nos deben de despertar and make us realize, wow, his coming is near. Su venida se acerca. I don't know the hour, no conozco la hora, but at least I know it's going to be soon, and he wants me to be watching. Él quiere que yo esté velando. Now listen, verse 44. You also must be ready at all the time. You must be ready all the time, for the Son of Man will come when least expected. Ustedes también deben de estar preparados todo el tiempo, porque el Hijo del Hombre vendrá cuando menos lo espere. This is told to Israel, to the people that are listening to Jesus. Esto se le dice a Israel, la gente que están escuchando a Jesús, but it applies to the church. Pero se aplica a la iglesia, that we have to be watchful, que tenemos que estar vigilantes. The Bible says that when he comes, will he find faith? Que cuando él venga, hallará fe en la tierra. And our job is that when he comes, he finds us doing his work. Que cuando él venga, nos encuentre haciendo su trabajo, su voluntad. Occupied, ocupado. Not just not doing anything. Because we have to respond for that. Tenemos que responder por eso. So how many praise God for his coming? ¿Cuánto dan gloria a Dios por su venida? Amen. I'll tell you like the old Christian, le digo como la iglesia antigua, Maranatha. Cristo viene pronto. Maranatha, Christ is coming soon. And I desire his coming. Yo deseo su venida. I desire. It's not only a sweet relief. Su venida no es solamente un alivio dulce. It is the beginning of the purpose of God in our life. Es el principio del propósito de Dios. Para su vida. I hope this has been a blessing for you. Ojalá que esto haya sido una bendición para su vida. I want you to know that today's Wednesday. Hoy es miércoles. Diácono, ¿hay alguna limpieza? No hay limpieza. There's no cleaning. Sunday, el domingo, God willing, we'll be here at 10 o'clock. I know Pastor Irma is going to be leading worship Sunday, so she's going to be here at 8. Hey, amen. I applaud that too. Huh? The rehearsal, 8:30 is rehearsal. So you can be here as early as 8:30 to find how can I help? What can I do? Can I pray? Listen, we got a whole church. Tenemos una iglesia entera. You want to go into one of the classrooms downstairs and pray? Ask for permission. We know you're down there. Go and pray. Váyase a orar. And I don't care if you walk up and down these chairs and touch them and pray for every person that sits on them. Padre, bendice cada persona que se siente, que haya salvación, que haya sanidad. Let's be radical for Jesus Christ. Vamos a ser radicales por Jesucristo. Don't ever walk through the church and just plop yourself down. Bend your knee. Pray. No entres por la iglesia y se sienta. No. Doble rodilla. Ore. My knees hurt. Well, stand up and walk and pray. Levántese, camine, ore. And this is the house of God, house of worship. Esta es la casa de Dios, casa de adoración. So I'm excited. I believe God has another word for you and me. Yo estoy excitado. Yo creo que Dios tiene una palabra para ti. Y para mí,
So let's be ready with our worship and to receive the word. Vamos a estar listos con nuestra adoración y para recibir la palabra. Let's stand up. Vamos a estar de pie. Su voluntad, eso es. Eso es exactamente. Lord, we need you more today than ever. Señor, te necesitamos más hoy que nunca. Without you, we already know we can't do it. Sin ti, ya sabemos que no lo podemos hacer. We're too weak. Somos muy débiles. Our hearts incline to sin. Nuestro corazón se inclina al pecado. There's temptation all around us. Hay tentación por doquier. There's testing. Hay prueba. The struggle is always real. La lucha siempre es real. But with you, we can do all things. Con ti todo lo podemos hacer. Your word testifies to that. Tu palabra testifica eso. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Filipenses 4:13, todo lo puedo en Cristo que me fortalece. Lord God, so we take hold of your promise. Señor, así que le echamos mano a tu promesa. We're believing that we are more than conquerors in Jesus Christ. Estamos creyendo que somos más que vencedores en Jesucristo. That we are going from glory to glory, que vamos de gloria en gloria, that there is healing in our bodies, que hay sanidad en nuestro cuerpo, that there's restoration in our mind, que hay restauración en nuestra mente, that we are blessed to be a blessing, que somos bendecidos para ser de bendición. Let us always be watching for your coming, for your return. Que siempre estemos vigilando, mirando y observando tu venida. That we would see the sign. Que veamos, oh Dios, los letreros, las señales. And that we would warn others at every opportunity. Y que, oh Dios, le demos la advertencia a todos los demás en cada oportunidad que tú nos des. Give us valor. Danos valor. Give us, oh Lord, courage. Danos ese coraje, valentía. That we would not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is power. Que no nos avergoncemos del evangelio de Jesucristo. Porque es poder. Poder for those who are saved. Para los que son salvos. Glorify your name. Glorifica tu nombre. We pray your blessing upon your church. Oramos tu bendición sobre tu iglesia. Over those that are watching, sobre los que están viendo, we pray, oh Lord, for your blessing to flow. That we would make our way, if you allow us, here on Sunday. Si tú nos permites que podamos llegar aquí el domingo. And let it be a glory on earth. Que sea una gloria sobre la tierra. To you be the glory and honor. A ti sea la gloria y la honra. In the name of Jesus. En el nombre de Jesús. And the people of God say. Y el pueblo de Dios dice. God bless you. We love you. We love you. Te amamos. Hallelujah. Huh?